Hi, this is Magnus with LMI. In Gocator 4.0 firmware, we have new support for a number of methods to generate a surface, or a 3D point cloud. In previous versions of the Gocator, the only way to generate a surface was using the built-in whole part detection logic. In Gocator 4.0 firmware, this is now called the continuous surface generation method with part detection. But in addition to that, we have three new methods that don't depend on part detection logic to deliver a surface. We have fixed length sequential, which will deliver back-to-back-to-back images like it's showing in this drawing. You can also use external input to trigger the start of a fixed length scan. With variable length surface generation, it will deliver an image while the external input is held high. And with rotational surface generation, we use the z-index of an encoder to reorder data so that the scan always starts at the same position. So to quickly show that off, I'm going to scan a few parts here with the Gocator 2330 line profiler. I have a small connector, black plastic ring, and a washer. So switching into the Gocator web interface here, I'm using the surface scan mode with the continuous surface generation method with part detection enabled. And as you can see, I have my settings set up here already to scan these parts. So when I scan slowly across here, each part will appear as a separate scan, a separate object. So this is just like the previous whole part mode. However, we now have this fixed length, variable length, and rotational surface generation method. So I'll show here the fixed length surface generation, 100 millimeter image size. And as I scan over this scene with my objects, parts on the belt, it will simply deliver this scan without any part detection logics, as you can see here. Now the other methods here, variable length and rotational, work exactly the same way. Thank you for listening.